evening once again, ladies and gentlemen, and we thank you for joining us this evening. We do apologize for our late start, but we ensure that the event will make up for this. As we are about to begin, we ask for your continued cooperation this evening, and we wish you an enjoyable event. Please ensure that you record your presence on the attendance register by clicking on the link in the chat and filling out the form. Know that students from Cave Hill, Mona, and St. Augustine campuses are required to fill out separate attendance registers. As such, please click and fill out the respective forms that correspond to your campus. We are currently circulating these links as well on our WhatsApp chats, as we are aware that there are technical difficulties. We would like to inform you that this event is being recorded for storage and archives. Therefore, to ensure the integrity of our production, we kindly ask for your audio and video functions to be turned off. It is now great pleasure and honor that I introduce our very hardworking and passionate president, Mrs. Anne-Marie Ming Han.
Thank you, Ranjeev, and good evening, everyone. Welcome to this historical inaugural event of the Pathology Club of UWI, and a special warm welcome to our colleagues from the Mona and Cavill campuses. My name is Anne-Marie Ming Han. I am the founder and president of the Pathology Club of UWI. I am truly honored to be before you today as we begin this journey together and make history with the very first pathology club of the University of the West Indies. We will commence with a prayer to bless the club and its journey. I ask at this time that we bow our heads and close our eyes, please. Thank you. Dear Lord, I want to thank you for making this day possible. Thank you for making what was once a far-fetched dream a reality. I ask that you bless us as we embark upon a historical journey as the very first pathology club of UWI, and as we aspire to positively impact not only the lives of club members, but of those around us. I pray that you guide us on this journey and give us the wisdom to act at all times and in all ways in the best interest of the club and its members. May the core values of honesty, integrity, credibility, humility, equality, respect, and so on be inexorably embedded into the core of the Pathology Club of UWI, such that, moving forward, we set a standard of excellence as we lay the foundation for future generations. In your precious name I pray, amen. Thank you. We will now officially commence this inaugural event of the Pathology Club of UWI. I will begin by providing you with the background of the club. The story behind my inspiration for making this club a possibility lies in a sentimental journey down memory lane. From a young age, I became engrossed with forensics crime drama television series such as CSI and NCIS. However, there was one specific character of the NCIS series that made an indelible impression in my young mind, Ducky, the medical examiner played by David McCallum. I watched on intently show after show as he solved riveting mysteries with only a human body as the narrative of the story. He gave the dead a voice and provided answers to family members, and so sparked my passion for forensic pathology. Despite this, however, there is no clear-cut algorithm of passion for pathology plus medical school equals pathology club that provides a simple and obvious answer as to why this club was born. Instead, the path to making this day a reality was preceded by an intricate journey of perpetual adversity that almost crushed my spirit and extinguished my passion. Yet, I overcame with all odds against me, and slowly my passion for pathology reignited until one day I was reminded of what first sparked my passion. It was the first day of mortuary for anatomical pathology clerkship at the Port of Spain General Hospital. We looked on as an autopsy was conducted within a mere 2 feet of us. And as I stood there, completely engrossed, I was reminded of my passion and why I dream of one day becoming a forensic pathologist. It was there that I met Dr. Catherine Morris, who introduced me to Dr. Alfredo Walker, and who, with the help of Professor AVC Rao, were all pivotal into making this club a reality. It would be remiss of me if I did not acknowledge each of them and thank them for their time, advice, encouragement, and support, without which the Pathology Club of UWI would not have been possible. There are no words to express how truly, truly grateful I am. On this note, it is with great honor that I introduce our advisory board members, Dr. Catherine Morris and Dr. Alfredo Walker. Dr. Alfredo Walker is a forensic pathologist at the Ottawa Hospital General Campus and is the Director of Education and a Vice Chair of the Department of Pathology and Laboratory Medicine at the University of Ottawa. He graduated with his MBBS in the year 1996 from our very own University of the West Indies here in St. Augustine, after which he pursued postgraduate training in both histopathology and subspecialty training in forensic pathology in the United Kingdom. He is a fellow of the Royal College of Pathologists and has a diploma in medical jurisprudence. He has won two University of Ottawa Teaching Awards in 2014 and 2017. Since 2012, Dr. Walker has been a visiting lecturer in forensic pathology for the Postgraduate Masters in Forensic Sciences program at the Mona campus of the University of the West Indies. He has also contributed to teaching for the Doctor of Medicine in Anatomical Pathology program. Dr. Walker actively publishes journals and internationally has either performed forensic post-mortem examinations or provided expert opinions for agencies in many countries such as the United Kingdom, Germany, Mauritius, Anguilla, St. Lucia, Trinidad and Tobago, and the Canadian provinces of Ontario, Quebec, British Columbia, and Canadian Territory of Nunavut. At this point, I would like to invite Dr. Walker to say a few words to the audience.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Can you hear me? Can you see me?
Yes, we are hearing you and seeing you, Dr. Walker.
I would just like to congratulate the Pathology Club of UWI on this very important step that it has taken to increase the awareness of pathology as a specialty in medicine and hopefully encourage many more students to seriously consider pathology as a postgraduate specialty in which to train. None of this would have been possible without the drive of Ms. Anne-Marie Minhon, who, from all indications, is destined to be a very good forensic pathologist. And it is in that regard, in my personal capacity as a forensic pathologist and National of Trinidad and Tobago, I will support her efforts and that of the Pathology Club of UWI, as well as with the backing of my own department of Pathology and Laboratory Medicine at the University of Ottawa, as well as the Eastern Ontario Regional Laboratory Association. We wish you all well. These two organizations would support all activities of the Pathology Club of UWI, and hope that it will be a very enjoyable experience, one which will also shape the professional futures of many persons who are on this call, as well as the wider UWI medical fraternity. Thank you. I just want to say in closing as well, on this Saturday, there is going to be an event which is held, which is going to be hosted by our department here in Ottawa in conjunction with the Office of the Chief Medical Examiner in Washington, D.C. This is the second of a tripartite series, and that's in custody in response to what happened in Minneapolis with the George Floyd case. As an incentive to you guys, I am offering free registration to participate in this second part, that's in custody two, international case studies, which is going to run from 2 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The president will disseminate the registration link for you guys. You will simply have to click on other complimentary registrant as the mode of payment for it to be completely free. So once again, I hope as many people as possible can log on, and thank you again.
Thank you, Dr. Walker, and thank you so much for inviting all UWI students to register free of charge. I was privileged to attend the first Death in Custody installment, and it truly was a wonderful experience. We were exposed to a lot of perspectives from experts in various fields, and I would definitely recommend that everyone can register for this Saturday. At this point, I would like to introduce Dr. Catherine Morris. Dr. Catherine Morris is a pathologist at the Port of Spain General Hospital and Next Gen Pathology. She obtained her medical degree from St. George's University School of Medicine in 2010, having obtained a full tuition scholarship courtesy the government of Trinidad and Tobago and her university. Having completed her internship at Port of Spain General Hospital, she completed a combined residency in anatomic and clinical pathology at the University of Tennessee Health Science Center in June 2017. She then went on to obtain fellowships in forensic pathology and cardiovascular pathology at Virginia Commonwealth University and Mayo Clinic, respectively. Having served in many leadership roles over her career, such as chief resident and her participation in several leadership courses, Dr. Morris was appointed an expert witness in the Richmond City Circuit Court and forensic pathologist at the Trinidad and Tobago Forensic Science Center. For her skilled and passionate work, she was awarded the Outstanding Autopsy Craftsmanship Award from the University of Tennessee Health Science Center. Dr. Morris is a member of the American Board of Pathologists, Pathology Society of Trinidad and Tobago, where she serves as its vice president, Society of Cardiovascular Pathology, and the United States and Canadian Academy of Pathology. She continues to have a passion for the development of pathology, as seen by her various presentations and publications, especially in the area of cardiovascular and forensic pathology. At this point, I would like to invite Dr. Morris to say a few words to the audience.
All right. Hello and good evening, everyone. Can everyone hear me and see me? I hope, because I can't see myself.
So. Yes, we can.
Okay, great. So I just, again, want to sort of reiterate what Dr. Walker said. I want to, you know, offer my admiration for Anne-Marie and the board's hard work in bringing all this together. I remember that day very clearly where I was talking to Anne-Marie about this, and we came up and suggested this idea, and I gave her a long list of things, and she went off very quietly and then came back with it done a couple of months later, which takes a lot of dedication and motivation, particularly when you have, you know, your full coursework and everything else on top. So I really think you cannot praise enough what has come out of it. I love pathology. I've always loved pathology. I became a doctor to do pathology. I would not have done medicine otherwise. But unfortunately, it is a specialty where there is a global shortage, if you all are not aware. And if you go to any international organization, there's always some part where we talk about how are we going to increase the number of pathologists. Because if you haven't noticed, most of us are not in my age group. They're a little older and they're getting ready to retire. And we need you all to come up and fill the ranks. And at the same time, while pathology is obtaining background, it's a specialty that underlies everything. Medicine cannot really go forward without us. We do the background research, we collect the samples, we figure out what is and is not a disease and define disease entities and prognoses and all that. We're integral to that process. And so we need you all. We need you all to pick it up and continue from where we went on. So the hope is with this group, particularly because the route coming from where you all are is a little bit convoluted. One, we can help you all to figure out if this is the right thing for you, help you to get there, and also to have fun. I mean, the hope is that this will be a fun thing, that it will be a light activity away from probably more disciplined activities of your coursework, where you can just delve into your interests and figure out why we love what we do so much. So I'm going to give it back to Anne-Marie and let her continue.
Thank you, Dr. Walker and Dr. Morris, for your kind words and advice. I will now hand you over to Amanda Francis, the Vice President, who will be introducing our executive board.
Good night, everyone. As Anne-Marie mentioned, my name is Amanda Francis, and I'll be serving as the Vice President for the year 2020-2021. It is with great pleasure that I introduce you to the Executive Board of the Pathology Club of UWI. I'll call upon each board member to share their name and a few lines about themselves. Firstly, I would like to introduce our treasurer, Kenesha Acha.
Good evening, once again, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Amanda. My name is Kenesha Achap, and I'll be serving as your treasurer for the academic year of 2020-2021. During my stay at Mount Hope, I've had the pleasure of being on various clubs, such as the Rotary Club of Mount Hope and The Pulse, which is a student-oriented magazine. And at these positions, I was able to meet various people who had a positive impact on my MBBS experience. I look forward to meeting each and every one of you in future events and activities. Thank you.
Thank you, Kenesha. Next, we have our secretary, Gia Francis.
Hi, everyone. Good evening. My name is Gia Francis, and I'm from the MBBS 2023 year group, and I will be serving as your secretary for the 2020 to the 2021 academic school year. I'm from the country of St. Lucia, and I enjoy dance and all things art and theater.
Thank you, Gia. Next, we have our public relations officer, Anthony Goddard.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Anthony Goddard, and I'll be serving as your PRO. I am a proud Sabigonian who enjoys socializing and learning about different cultures and tasting different foods. I'm a national judge and a national archer. And in my pastime, away from all the studying, I love playing with my animals and shredding on my skateboard.
Okay, thank you, Anthony. Next, we have our stunt PRO, Samantha Simbu.
Hi, everyone. I'm Samantha Simbu, and I am from MBBS 2022, and I will be your assistant PRO for the next academic year. I would just like to share one thing about myself. I'm a professional henna artist, so I love doing mehendi designs, so y'all can contact me whenever necessary, and I look forward to working with each and every one of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Samantha. And last but not least, we have our trustee, Ranjiva Bridgelal.
Good evening once again, ladies and gentlemen. As said, my name is Ranjiva Bridgelal, and I'll be serving as your trusted trustee for the upcoming academic year. I'm an aspiring forensic pathologist who loves everything Caribbean, especially its food, its people, and of course, its music. And now we will highlight the newly refined mission statement, aims, vision, statement, and of the Pathology Club of UWI, in addition to some of its future plans.
Okay, thank you, Ranjiva. So I'll now highlight the mission statement, aims, and vision of the club. Just to give everyone an idea of the foundation the club will be built upon. So firstly, our mission statement states that we would like to increase students' awareness of and interest in pathology and laboratory medicine and foster relationships between Caribbean medical students and experts in pathology and laboratory medicine through education, mentorship, and research opportunities. Next, I would like to tell you about our aims. So firstly, we would like to increase students' interest and awareness of pathology and laboratory medicine. We would like to provide preclinical medical students with early exposure to pathology and laboratory medicine. We would like to increase students' understanding of pathology and laboratory medicine and the integral role of pathologists in all relations and realms of medicine. We'd also like to foster a relationship between Caribbean medical students and experts in pathology and laboratory medicine via mentorship, shadowing, training, and research opportunities. We'd also like to highlight pathology and laboratory medicine in the Caribbean as a respected field. And then we have our vision statement. The vision of the Pathology Club of UWI is to foster Caribbean medical students interested in pathology and laboratory medicine, and provide support to those aspiring to specialize in pathology and laboratory medicine through mentorship, shadowing, and research opportunities across the medical sciences faculty of the St. Augustine, Mona, and Capehill campuses. These excerpts from our constitution allude to what we see in the future of the Pathology Club of UWI. We hope to see growth and development of the club through establishing a solid foundation in the upcoming year. We aim to do this through recruiting more active members, hosting events that appeal to you as the student body and accentuate your learning experience, and paving the way for innovation and a new experience in the medical sciences faculty. Some future plans that we hope to execute in the future include the Year 3 Bootcamp and CPAMSI, which will be discussed further in the next presentation, the Adopt a Student initiative that will provide the opportunity to interact with experts in various fields as they guide students through research and offer mentorship. This would serve to assist students in publishing and sharing their research. We'd also like to fund at least one research project in pathology in future and to offer experience in shadowing and clinical exposure. We truly hope to bring all these plans into fruition to create a holistic experience. Thank you. I'd now like to hand you over to Gia Francis, and she will elaborate further on the Year 3 Bootcamp and CPAMSI initiative.
Okay. Thank you, Amanda. So the Pathology Club of UWI has so far been working on a few events and projects for our members, and a few of them are still in the works. However, we really wanted to tell you all about two major projects that we intend to launch very soon. Firstly, we have the Caribbean Pathology and Laboratory Medicine Student Initiative, which we've abbreviated as CPAMSI. This is an initiative that has been established by the Pathology Club of UWI in collaboration with Dr. Alfredo Walker and Dr. Catherine Morris, and is supported by the Department of Pathology and Laboratory Medicine of the University of Ottawa and the Eastern Ontario Regional Laboratory Association. The goal of this initiative is to expose Caribbean medical students to various fields within the scope of pathology and laboratory medicine through a series of consultant-led talks supplemented by resident-led talks. We also hope to foster interest and relationships between students and experts in this field. So the intended objectives of these talks, so we have to provide students with an overview of the specialty, to provide them with a gateway into the specialty, and to also provide a few case examples to show the scope of the practice and the benefits of choosing this specialty. So these objectives would be achieved through 60-minute interactive sessions, which will be held fortnightly throughout the academic year, in order to provide a well-rounded overview of all the disciplines constituting pathology and laboratory medicine. Our first session would be held next week, Thursday, that's the 13th of August, from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. So we really hope that everybody comes out and register. We have eager and willing pathologists and experts in the field of laboratory medicine waiting to speak on numerous branches ranging from forensic pathology to molecular pathology, cardiovascular pathology, and so much more. What I personally appreciate about this initiative is that our executive members have been working tirelessly to ensure that the presentations correspond to the syllabi from year one onwards. For example, the year ones would have just done gastro and cardiovascular systems, and we have sessions set to provide an insight into the surgical pathology specialties of gastrointestinal and cardiovascular pathology. For third years, we have an insight into hematology and transfusion medicine, and for our clinical year students, we have pediatric and perinatal pathology and so on. I hope everyone is as excited about this initiative as we are, but we have one more, and that would be the Year 3 Bootcamp. And the concept behind this initiative is based on the difficulty to transition from Year 2 into Year 3. So that's basically from preclinical to paraclinical sciences, and the overarching tone of pathology in all aspects of our syllabi. With this project, we aim to hold a session for incoming third years that will consist of general advice from the fourth years on how to manage the various blocks and the various components of the third year syllabus. So year four volunteers would provide support by giving tips on the content and the various blocks, as well as advice as how to tackle them based on their experience and whilst appealing also to the different learning and studying styles. As a club, we aim for this project to assist year threes with clerkships, PDQs, OSPE, OSCE, 3311, 3312, and 3313 blocks. The tentative date for this project is the 27th of August, and it is scheduled to take place between 5 p.m. and 9 p.m., as we've realized that is the time that most students are able to you know, attend. I should also mention that apart from just advice, we also hope that the year four volunteers would be speakers, and they would have small and engaging sessions via our online platforms such as Microsoft Teams or Zoom. And we hope that these sessions would be interactive and as welcoming as possible to basically erase the whole stoic nature of mentorship and to make everyone feel as comfortable as possible to receive advice and or help and to ask questions. Thank you, and now we'll have our PRO and assistant PRO, Anthony and Samantha, and they will speak on the progress of and the intentions for our social media platforms.
Thank you, Gia. Good evening, everyone, again. Anthony and I will be speaking a little on our social media page and upcoming social events. So there are three platforms which we currently have: Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. And of course, there's a hope of creating a TikTok account, but that remains tentative. However, I would just elaborate on the Instagram account. So with respect to our Instagram account, I'm sure you remember our mini spotters which took place over the past 2 weeks. And I must say that the response received from you guys were commendable. A job well done. Don't worry, we have way more content in stock for you guys. We will be posting cases and questions on a weekly basis for you to challenge your brains and promote critical thinking. Cases would integrate many disciplines. However, the main focus would be pathology. You will be required to DM us your answers in order to participate. Answers and explanations to said cases would be posted 24 hours after for you to see how well you really know your work. Along with the post, there will be links where you can source more information on the specific topic. Additionally, we plan to be even more interactive with you guys by creating mini quizzes, polls, and challenges, which gives you a chance to directly interact with us. So don't forget to follow us on Instagram at the Pathology Club of UWI. Lots of fun activities are coming your way, and I will now pass over to Anthony to elaborate further.
Good day, everyone, and thank you, Samantha. Now, these mini questions presented to you on our Instagram page, the Pathology Club of UWI, were a success. The engagement the club had with some of our members proved that these stories were a big hit. While creating a friendly and learning environment where information based on pathology, anatomy, etc., were easily learned. Now we have what does the club have for you? We have exercise your brain matter. These are real cases that were presented on our Instagram and Facebook pages. Then in the Instagram and Facebook carousel, it will be further explained using anatomy, pathophysiology, and more. So look out for that. Next, we have our Member of the Month Award. This is for you, our members. And it goes to the member who displays excellence, passion, dedication, humility, and who has attended at least 75% of the meetings and or events. The member awarded will have privilege such as taking part in the club's activities and decision making, research projects, and training opportunities. And this also makes them eligible to be elected on the executive board. And this is just the tip of the iceberg of what we have for you. We are also hoping to have a lot of events and opportunities, competitions, and webinars in the future. So also look out for that. Despite COVID-19, as a club, we are trying our best to engage as much as possible with our members. Remember to join our social media accounts: Instagram, the Pathology Club of UWI; Facebook, the Pathology Club of UWI; and on YouTube as well, the Pathology Club of UWI. Thank you so much, and I'll now hand you over to Kanisha for a fun and interactive activity. Take it away.
Thank you, Anthony. Now, for those of you who logged in late, so I'll just repeat the instructions. We would like you now to open up a new tab and log on to the Slido website and enter the code seen displayed on the screen. When logging in, when you're using your username, you can either use your real name or a nickname, and in brackets, please enter your year group, so example 2021, 2022, etc., followed by a capital A for those from the St. Augustine campus, a capital C for those from the Cave Hill, and capital M for those from Mona. We'll just wait 2 more minutes for those to join the session. Okay, guys, the first question is up, and please answer quickly because the questions are timed. So we have 71% of you guys got the correct answer. And the correct answer for what color tube is used for glucose testing was a gray top tube. Now let's see our leaderboard to see who's in the lead. So we have Nail from class of 2021, St. Augustine campus in the lead, with Niels from 2022 in a close second. Then we have Amrit, KR, and Paw Patrol on the board. So come on guys, you have 4 more questions and a chance to get on the leaderboard. Now we move on to the next question. Which of the following histological feature is found in rabies? A. Caudry, but A. B. Nigri bodies, or C. Guanari bodies? You have 5 more seconds to answer. Now let's see the results. Now we have 88% of you guys got the correct answer. Well done. So now let's see the leaderboard to see if anything changed. So now we have Niels in first place. Cheryl Didier is coming up in second. We still have KVR and Niall and Paw Patrol still on the leaderboard. Now guys, try and answer as fast as possible to be able to get on the leaderboard. Next question. What proto-oncogene is associated with invasive carcinoma of the breast? A, BCR, ABL, B, HER2, C, EGFR, or D, RAS? So now we have 49% of you guys getting the correct answer. Now let's see if the leaderboard stays the same or if we have new persons on it. So Niels maintains her first place lead, Cheryl Didier and Paw Patrol and KVR are still on the leaderboard. But now we have Anissa who takes fourth place. Well done. Next question. Okay, 2 more questions, guys. So a meningioma is the most common type of brain parenchymal tumor. Is this true or false? Okay, now let's see the answer. So we have a split. So 52% said true and 48% said false. The correct answer was false. Now let's see the leaderboard. So we see that Niels and Paw Patrol, Anissa and KVR are still on the leaderboard, along with Cheryl. I'm seeing 2022 and 2024 on leaderboard. Come on, 2023, 2021. You can do it. This is the last question now. What inherited hematological disorder contains the following cells in the peripheral blood film? 1 target cells, 2 nucleated red blood cells, or 3 hypochromic cells. Is it hemophilia A, beta thalassemia, von Willebrand's disease, or G6PD deficiency? You guys, you have 10 more seconds. And now let's see the answers. So we have 63% getting correct. The correct answer is beta thalassemia. And this is the final question, so let's see who's on the leaderboard now. So now we have Paw Patrol who takes first place. So class of 2024 is in first place on behalf of Paw Patrol. We have Niels, Anissa, and Cheryl Didier who's representing class of 2022 in second and fourth place. And we have Gail in 5th place representing class of 2021. Thank you so much for playing, guys, and I hope you had fun. Now I'll hand you back to our presentation.
Thank you, Kanisha, for that fun activity. I truly hope everyone enjoyed it. At this time, I would like to introduce you to our featured speaker, Professor AVC Rao. Dr. Chalapathi Rao Adidam Venkata of the Faculty of Medical Sciences. Throughout his career, Dr. Rao Adidam Venkata has demonstrated strong commitment and dedication to his profession and has worked for more than 28 years in both the didactic and problem-based learning methodologies. The research on hormone receptor and HER2 new study in breast cancer was first in the Caribbean and had a significant impact with the spin-off of being introduced as a routine testing for breast cancer management. Other areas of his special interest include wound healing and renal disease. He has published in peer-reviewed journals and also established direct immunofluorescence study service and provides support for renal transplant pathology at the UWI Faculty of Medical Sciences. Besides this, he is also working on providing electron microscopy service and research in various clinical areas. Currently, he is also providing immunohistochemistry service in cancer diagnosis. External assessors considered his contribution as clinically important and demonstrates insight into the role of pathology within the academic setting. Dr. Rao Adidam Venkata teaches at the undergraduate and postgraduate levels. He was awarded a Guardian Life Premier Teaching Award in 2012 and also established a pathology museum and promotes digital pathology for students at the faculty. He is also a consultant in pathology, providing diagnostic pathology services at different hospitals. At this time, it was with great pleasure that I invite Dr. Chalapathi Rao Adidam Venkata, or as we fondly know him here at the Faculty of Medical Sciences, Professor Rao, to deliver his feature address.
Thank you, Anne-Marie. Good evening, Team Pathology Club, all my dear students, Dr. Morris and Dr. Alfredo Walker, and all my viewing and listening special audience. It gives me an immense pleasure and honor to be associated with this unique pathology club of UWI. This is a brainchild of Ms. Anne-Marie and Dr. Catherine Morris and Dr. Walker. I had no hesitation in being a part of it and nurturing this concept. Exemplary efforts of Anne-Marie and her wonderful team have culminated in today's event. Today is truly a special day. I'm sure you will strive to keep the club vibrant and productive to realize its objectives and goals. I urge you all to encourage others to enroll in this club. With best wishes, I will now start my address tailored to all my beloved students at various campuses. Now, my address, you have the, I think, Anne-Marie, can you ask the PowerPoint to be taken control of? Yeah. And my address comprises of the contents as given in this PowerPoint presentation, which includes pathology, my journey, medical school, and future department of pathology. Now, as you all know, pathology is the medical specialty which provides a scientific basis for medical practice, and it encompasses many disciplines. This pathology bridges preclinical and clinical sciences and patient and the clinician. This is a very interesting and enjoyable branch of medicine. Royal College of Pathologists state that pathology is the clinical diagnostic science that underpins patient care. Now, pathology, there are various disciplines or sub-disciplines. You can say you have chemical pathology, immunopathology, like that. My area of interest is anatomic pathology, which comprises of surgical pathology, cytopathology, and autopsy pathology. Anatomic examinations generally involve both gross and microscopic examination of tissues. Now, who is a pathologist and why is a pathology so important? So many of people have very little idea of what pathology is. If you ask anyone, including medical students, oh, well, pathology is he just do postmortems. That is the idea what the lay public as well as some medical students have. No, it is not true. Pathologist is a doctor's doctor. The pathologists are physicians who specialize in the diagnosis and management of human disease by laboratory methods. For this, you need to be a medical graduate and you have to have MBBS degree, and later on, you have to do your residency to specialize in pathology. And after that, you can subspecialize in areas like neuropathology, cardiovascular, etc. So once you are qualified pathologist, now the options are open for you, whether you can be employed at universities or public sector, or you can also get employment in private sector, or you can start your own labs. Generally, a patient physician, you don't generally interact directly with the patient, but you more often interact with the physician, unlike a general physician or a doctor. Now, when a patient says, my doctor diagnosed me with cancer or breast cancer, who is it? It is the pathologist who makes the diagnosis. So he is in the background assisting and guiding the clinician or the surgeon. Now, for example, you will understand the importance of the laboratory medicine or pathology here in this example. For example, a simple common entity, which is the pregnancy. How will you diagnose? Even with the best of the clinician, definitely he needs a laboratory diagnosis of pregnancy at the early stages. That is the proof of pregnancy. He, no matter the amount of clinical acumen he has, he will not be able to conclusively diagnose pregnancy at an early stage. Similarly, COVID testing, it is so rampant now. And unless you prove that you have COVID, there are so many cases where you can have flu-like symptoms, but to make a diagnosis, you need assistance of laboratory. Of course, absolute necessity of pathology to modern medicine. And this pathology plays a pivotal role in the diagnosis, management, prognostication, monitoring of the disease, and also beyond, even we can identify newer and emerging diseases, and we can solve mysteries. Now, how have the advancements in technology changed the landscape of pathology? Now, remember the stakeholders, which include the health professionals, wherein we are waging war against the disease on a day-to-day basis. Now, these evil forces are there in the nature or environment, or within us, infringe upon our health, are at a constant play in day to day and are innovative as well. And you see the organisms and all, they are very intelligent, and you need advancements in technology and knowledge, and that is inevitable to combat these evil forces. Now, how it all began, if you see pathology history, in ancient times, it was mainly autopsy, which was the source of information about the disease. But later on, microscopy was introduced in mid 19th century, and the first pathology lab was established in 1881 in New York. Now, autopsy is so interesting, you will not believe. This is the one which provides a voice for the dead, and it will solve so many mysteries, particularly in forensic pathology. And who does it? It is we pathologists who do it. And often previously, the pathologists were considered to be introverted. They are in their room in an armchair, chained to the microscope for several decades. But now the current scenario is totally different. Now, for example, what happens to a lung biopsy? Now, when a lung biopsy reaches a pathology lab, the pathologist will diagnose the cancer, but not only that, he will subtype, grade, and also indicate the state of invasion and margins. And besides that, it is further advanced by the additional techniques, what we call the immunohistochemistry, where you use specific tumor markers to identify the cell of origin. And it doesn't end there. You can further proceed with molecular testing for specific mutations, for example, EGFR, wherein the oncologist has information so that he can specifically treat. That is called targeted therapy in a patient's cancer. Now, of course, now you see the advancement. You see the molecular pathology revolutionizing medicine, and pathologists, of course, plays a very important or a key role. Now, technological advances today are changing the game of pathologists and to unlock mysteries. The major goal of modern medicine is to increase the patient specificity so that right treatment is administered to right patient at the right time in the right dose. So that means pathologists help doing right things and also do things right. So the rise of precision medicine in the area of oncology is inevitable and it is taking an important center stage. Now you see in this diagram in the next slide, you see here onto your left, the pathologist, which the previously the diagnosis was based on the experience and knowledge of a senior pathologist. Nowadays, you need evidence-based. Next slide, please. And this evidence-based, as I told you, requires the immunohistochemistry, other ancillary methods to make a specific diagnosis. And as I told you, it doesn't end there, but you proceed with the precision medicine wherein you study various mutational events for what is called therapies that are even more personalized medicine. So you have specific treatment for a specific type of cancer with specific mutations. Now, of course, you will not be surprised. Artificial intelligence is entering into the field of pathology also. It has already entered in radiology, and also we have seen reports wherein the artificial intelligence, the capability is far superior to the radiologist as far as the percentage of accuracy is concerned. But it will take, as I see the complexity of pathology, AI will take longer time to be introduced. Maybe it will take few decades. Now, have these changes influenced my research and that of UWI? Yes, of course. There has been a lot of impact on my research too. In fact, I had started my research with immunohistochemistry even as I was doing my post-graduation thesis, which I did on S100 in tumor pathology way back in mid-80s. Now, let us go into the journey. So, where it all began? Where am I from? Of course, I am from Mysore, India, that is the southern part of India. And life before medicine, of course, was quite comfortable, well supported by my parents to scale the ladder of career and life. My father, you can see in this diagram or the big photograph here to the right, he was professor of chemistry and dean of science college. And my mother is there next to him. She is an arts and crafts teacher and a homemaker. Now, all the time, my focus was on studies before medicine and played games like badminton, cricket, and indoor games. Now, what inspired me to pursue medicine? Of course, the dramatic improvement of my mom's health following valvular surgery at one of the leading hospitals in India. It dramatically improved her health and it changed our lives a lot. And of course, you had a lot of competition to get into medicine, which was quite prestigious at that time. And also only cream of the A-level corresponding students who can secure a medical seat out of millions, it was really a prestigious issue and we were working hard for that and the competition was intense. Now, I studied at Mysore Medical College. You can see the image here. This place, Mysore is a city of palaces and even the medical college has a structure of the palace here and also the hospital has a similar structure. Now, in our experience as a medical student, we had first 3 years of pre and paraclinical and 3 years of clinical, but paraclinical and clinical years were overlapped in our 5-year course so that we can relate pathology to clinical medicine. So you have parallelly clinical posting as well as pathology to understand both well. Now, of course, the medicine, learning medicine, etc. It changed my life. It improved my confidence and self-reliance. And it was a stepping stone to achieve my life goals. And also, it gave me recognition, a lot of recognition in my society. And what are the setbacks during my MBBS days? Of course, unlike you, wherein you have a list of objectives, what we have is no syllabus. When you go to a teacher, they would just say, you have to study the entire topic. So that was the answer. And also exams were solely based on essay questions, which was quite tough. and clinical exam was based on one long case and short cases, which was really a lot of stressful on the examinations. Now, what is the post after medical school? What really happened? Now, soon after medical school, we enrolled ourselves in the internship, and as soon as we completed internship, we didn't have much time. We proceeded to postgraduate study, and I chose to do the post-graduation in clinical pathology because I loved pathology, and the inspiration was we used to have the clinical pathological conferences where the pathologist was making the final diagnosis. Soon after I completed my internship, I proceeded with post-graduation, and the inspiration for post-graduation was mainly the CPC or the clinical pathological conferences wherein the pathologist used to make the final diagnosis and everyone was eagerly waiting for their findings and to pronounce the final diagnosis and know what exactly is going on. And that was really impressive. And that was one of the inspirations for me to join. And I did join post-graduation in clinical pathology and proceeded with the postgraduate degree in pathology at Kasturba Medical College, Manipal. And here I have the campus. Here you can see the administration building of Kasturba Medical College, Manipal, on to your right. And below, I have two of my professors. One is Dr. K. Ram Narayan and Dr. Professor Ravikala Rao, who are the ones who have inspired and influenced me in my career. And they are senior professors, and they are humble and down-to-earth, excellent individuals. And I cannot forget them. Their contribution to pathology and to my life is immense. And soon after, immediately after completing my post-graduation, I joined as a lecturer in the same college and served for 8 years, and I was promoted to the associate professor. And how did I come to UWI, and how did I end up coming from the other part of the world altogether, directly opposite from the East? In fact, I didn't know at that point where Trinidad was. And the reason why I came here was there was a twinning program where the University of West Indies and Kasturba Medical College, Manipal, had a twinning program where we shared the medical students, and they used to swap after 2.5 years the campuses, and they used to study. And when the team from UWI came, they indicated that they were short staffed as far as pathology is concerned, and they needed some additional hands to teach pathology. So that's how I was seconded from UWI. And when I came here, of course, the Trinidad was quite homely. The climate exactly was the same as that of Manipal, and I was assigned to established pathology museum for teaching, and also teaching and learning resources, and also support teaching at UWI. So in the process, which took some time, and I extended my contract. Meanwhile, my family had established here. My children was already started studying in their school, and my wife was also employed. You can see my family here. My wife, who is a dermatologist and venereologist, she is head of QPCC now. And my son, he is a house officer in cardiology. And my daughter, who is an Odissi dancer, as well as a TV and radio anchor, she is now doing residency at Washington in internal medicine. Of course, I'm here in that photograph. And of course, my son, he was also a founding president of two societies, and that is the Art Society of Mount Hope and also the Astronomy Society. And this is my family, and of course, they were also quite supportive in continuing at Trinidad. Now, let me take you to a long professional journey. Now, I have a substantial experience of nearly 35 years in pathology, and I had applied the teleological approach of the tripartite mission of teaching, diagnostic pathology, and research. So I try to see that whenever I do certain things, it has to be helpful to the community or the patient. So that was my goal. Even research, I want to translate this research, what can be applied into day-to-day practice. And of course, the contributions in all three areas were critical in my achieving professorship. Of course, there was difficulty in achieving this because you have ups and downs during the career where you have to struggle to publish and try to get as many publications out in addition to teaching and diagnosis. Of course, I could manage that with perseverance and being goal-oriented. Now, what are my future aspirations? Personally, of course, in these days, I need to keep safe and healthy and provide support to my family. And of course, medically, I would continue steadfastly to provide diagnostic services to best of my ability and seize every opportunity to expand horizons and introduce new tests, etc. in the department, which I have done from day one. And academically, of course, I try to improve the curriculum for undergraduate teaching, innovate teaching and learning methods, tailored to the current context now, we are going more online and also pursue research as before. Now, medical school, of course, what are the pointers to get through a medical school for a student? Of course, the advice to my beloved student when they face the stress and challenges. Of course, when you decide to join your medical school, stress is inevitable. Now, you have a challenge, but if you don't have resources that can effectively deal with that challenge, you end up in a stressful situation. Most of the time, the reason why students have stress is lack of time, volume, and pace of learning, understanding topics. Sometimes you feel it is overwhelming quite often, and you feel as if you are given water from the fire hydrant to drink. It is so difficult, and you succumb to these pressures. And remember, also, not all disciplines are interesting. It varies with students. Some students like anatomic pathology, some are good in pharmacology, and these variations will be there in the student, but as a student, you have to study all the subjects. Now, of course, sometimes stress can be positive and will help you in your growth. Now, as far as the management of stress is concerned, I feel stress is best managed by yourself. The stress management is in your hands. You should take care of it and see that your overall mental health is fine. Never allow to slip into mental health issues, which is not good at all for the student. I believe that the intrinsic motivation is more lasting and brings about better results as compared to extrinsic. No amount of me or anyone giving a pep talk will help. If you are intrinsically motivated, no one can stop you. And of course, stress also will not touch you when you are intrinsically motivated. And my take on this topic is stay focused, be goal-oriented, avoid unnecessary distractions, and balance your activities and see that you manage your time well. And keep good company and keep healthy sleep schedule. And you have to study smart than smart. Now, of course, if you cannot manage, of course, there are always support groups and mentors. Of course, lastly, you do have professional and psychiatric counseling. Of course, that is the last few steps when you cannot cope up with the stress. Now, future of the department, yes. Now, where are we headed with respect to students? I'm not talking about the other aspects. It is related to the students. Of course, we have curriculum changes wherein they are trying to split courses so that it's much easier for the students. And now with the COVID, we have more of online delivery of course content. And my only issue is about the observance of autopsies, etc., which will be difficult from this year. We have to see how we have to work on it. And of course, we are trying intensively to introduce DM pathology because number of house officers and graduates are waiting to do DM in pathology. We are trying our best to introduce. So I hope it will be introduced soon. Now, personally, what I see for particularly the St. Augustine campus is the MDSC, that is the basic paraclinical sciences, that the year one, 1002, and year three courses are separated far apart. I would like to bring them closer because you need to know basic paraclinical sciences to understand the systemic pathology or the subject content of year three courses. They are far apart, almost 2 years. and also extend year three. Now we have only 1.5 semesters. You need at least 2 full semesters because the volume of material you have to imbibe and assimilate is quite huge. So you need at least 2 full semesters, and I have been fighting for all this for long years. And year three and clinical posting should be together so that you can integrate clinical and pathology findings. Of course, the forensic pathology is completely missing in our curriculum, which I would like to add that is very important. And in fact, during our student days, forensic medicine was a separate course and we had to pass that, and it was a separate subject altogether. And of course, as regards to research and advancements and investment and expansion, the resource constraints limits our expansion to research, and also we have limited material in some areas. For example, if you want to do a research on breast cancer, to get around 100 cases, it takes a very long time. So we have limited material to do excellent research compared to large countries where you can get 3,000-4,000 breast cancer cases to study, both from pathology and its clinical assessments. Now, of course, faculty is trying to boost the research at their level, so they are trying their best. So in closing, I would like to congratulate Ms. Anne-Marie and her team for this outstanding achievement, and please continue this journey with pride and honor. And thank you again for giving me this opportunity. Thank you very much. And what you see in the next picture, of course, would be the palace of my hometown in Mysore, which is illuminated on festival days and on public holidays. So you can see that in the inset in the picture there. So thank you very much for patient hearing, and sorry for the technical issue in between, and it was beyond my control, so I switched over to my mobile. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Rao, for your truly inspirational story and your candor. As William Faulkner quoted, gratitude is a quality similar to electricity. It must be produced and discharged and used up in order to exist at all. And as such, we would like to extend a hearty thank you to all those who have assisted in making this evening successful and bringing this club to life. Firstly, we would like to extend our profound gratitude to our featured speaker and our very own academic advisor, Professor AVC Rao, for his insightful and thorough presentation. Your presentation truly offered essential details, and your explanations were extremely informative. You are truly an inspiration in the field of pathology, and we thank you for your agreement to come on board as our academic advisor and for your wonderful guidance. We'd also like to extend thanks to our advisory board, Dr. Catherine Morris and Dr. Alfredo Walker, for guiding us and assisting us in molding the club thus far. We appreciate your dedication and all the knowledge and time you have offered. Additionally, we're extremely grateful for all students and guests present tonight. A special thank you and acknowledgement to students from the Mona and Cape Hill campuses who joined us tonight. We are thankful for the Mona and Cape Hill students and all of you who came tonight. We are thankful for your participation and interest in the club, and we would like to look forward to an exciting year of learning and camaraderie with you all. Thank you, and I'd like to extend to Anne-Marie to give the closing statement.
Thank you, Amanda. I truly hope that everyone enjoyed this inaugural event and is looking forward to this first CPAMC session next week and other activities we have planned. I would just like to leave everyone with a final thought. Choose to see the world not simply as it is, but as what it can be, an enigma of possibilities. We each possess the ability to make an incredible difference, not only in the lives of others, but in the world around us. Don't ever give up. Don't ever let anyone or any circumstance crush your spirit or trample your dreams. Stand up for what you believe in, stay true to yourself, and never lose heart. Good night, everyone.